next operation is filing. Okay, so suppose for example I want to file the broader side. Let's forget about the narrow sides. I want to file the broader sides. Okay, so this is the piece. We have noticed that these are the raw cuts which are made by Exo, but these are the parallel sides which are, because on the material, they are straight. Okay, so we know that these two sides are parallel. So the best way to hold the jaw will be the parallel sides onto the workpiece. Okay, so open the vise and hold the jaw. Make sure it is slightly above the jaw lines. Okay, slightly above the jaw line. While tightening, make sure you place your head on top so that there is no accident, means jaw can fly onto your face if it is not tightened properly. Okay, so I'll pick here a file. Okay, so when you are holding the tools, okay, when you are using the tools, make sure the handles are properly fitted. Okay, all the tools which are using should be properly in proper shape. Okay, if you see anything coming out and all, do not use it. Okay, put them aside. Use only the proper tools. Okay, so here I am using a rough file. So already seen the last session. Okay, so I want to remove this rust, the coating of the raw material. Okay, so what the material will look like? It will look like a steel. It will look like a silver, shiny. Okay, right now it is dark black. You have to remove that coating and the rust. Okay, for that I am again taking the same position, my left foot in front. Okay, but this time I am slightly towards my left side so that I can work with my right hand nicely. Okay, place your file on top of the job. You can see it has maintained a balance because it is nicely level. But when you come here, it will not maintain the balance. It will fall down. Here also it will fall down. So you have to make sure you maintain the balance. That is how you have to start. Okay, maintain the file level on the surface throughout. Don't allow it to fall down. Okay, one side. Always flat on the surface. Okay, and this material is hard. Tool is hard. So you are not getting anything. Okay, you can see nothing is happening. But the reason is because both are hard. We need to make one of them softer, especially the material. We have to turn them into soft material. This is hard. We have to turn them into soft material. How we will do that? Very simple. Okay, when you rub your hands, what you can feel? There is a friction and there is a heat. Due to the friction, there is a heat. Okay, so then same heat we have to create here. Okay, by friction, by rubbing the file over the jaw, you have to create the friction and heat. Okay, right now the jaw I can feel it is cold. Cold means the material is very hard. Okay, after some time, okay, you have to keep doing this and use the file throughout from tip to heel. Okay, how you did for the Exo, from tip to heel, very straight. This is called the straight file. Keep doing this. Beginning you might see that nothing is happening, but after some time you feel that resistance. Okay, the file is gripping on the surface. Okay, and your jaw is slightly turning warm. Okay, after some time it will be hot. Jaw will be hot and it will be soft. Once it is hot, it is soft. Metal is soft, and then you can perform your operations nicely. Can you see this shining part? Actually the material is coming out. Okay, you can see the shining part now, and the powder is coming out. So you can see this all metal powder is coming out, and we are getting it. Okay, so as soon as you get the heat, you can work nicely. Okay, I can feel the resistance. See how I am using the file. I am using the file straight, flat, and throughout from tip to heel. I am not doing this way. This is the wrong way. You are just wasting your energy. So use the total length of the file. Out. And after filing this, you have to use the tri square to check the level. Alright, you have to check the level with the tri square. So allow the light to pass, and the light will show you whether it is high or low. Okay, right now we cannot see anything, but you have to see this in the light. Okay, so before that, I will just complete the three operations on the filing. This is the straight filing. Okay, so begin to file the smoother sides. Okay, and the other one is cross filing. you have to just put the file cross and you have to go forward. So in straight filing we cover only this much of area, in cross filing we cover the whole area. In cross filing is required when you remove the more amount of material. Okay, the cross filing where you want more filing to remove the material. Okay, this is the straight filing. The third one is the draw filing. Okay, with the draw filing normally we use only the smooth file. Okay, that is for finishing. You have to hold the file this way at the center, not on the handle, then you have to go forward. Okay, you can see the file covers the total area of the job one shot and it will not remove any material. If you see after filing draw, you will not see hardly see any material, okay, because it will just polish the surface giving you finishing look. Okay, these are the three types of filing: straight filing, cross filing and draw filing. You have to use them as per your requirement. Okay, so also you can use different types of files. Okay, like triangular file, 6-inch triangular file. This will be required in these situations where you require to prepare the corners. You cannot use flat file. Okay, you have to go for the triangular file to prepare the corners and all. Okay, and such. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Friends, while working, it is also very important to maintain your safety practices. Okay. So while working, make sure you don't injure anyone else. Okay. So when you are doing something, make sure no one is around you. That is why the vices which are there, they are far away. They are not very close to each other. So that the other person should be safely away from the first person. So that is you have to practice. And the other things is the safety in the surrounding. Okay, so you can see this is a large area, anything can happen. Okay, so you might have to leave the place immediately. For that you should know the proper exits, the doors close by, this is the closest one to you. Okay, don't take the longest route, always use the closest escape route. Okay, while evacuating any emergency situation. Okay, that is the fire extinguisher. Okay, so this is the in situation of fire, if something happens, if it is the fire is small, you can attack the fire by using a fire extinguisher. Okay, for that at least you should know the fire points where they are situated. Okay, the locations of the all fire extinguishers. One you can see is on this side. And if you need to use it, you can read the instruction on it. Okay, you have to take out the safety pin and all. Okay, at all it will be the last option. Otherwise, at least you should know the location of the fire extinguisher and what are the alternative. Okay, we might also have the sand available to extinguish the fire. Okay, sand station, fire extinguisher. And okay, these things you have to take care. Safety is very important in the workshop, as I told. I will keep on repeating the safety measures as we. Wow. Okay, so we have the raw material which is required to prepare the job. Okay, so we have to prepare this job for the marking. We have to prepare all the sides because all these sides are uneven, we don't know. Okay, all this rough cuts, this coating, we don't know. We have to remove that by filing and prepare it for the marking. Okay, right now as I told you, we have to start with the broader sides. Okay, so all together we have 6 sides, 2 broader sides and 4 narrow sides. Okay, so we are going to start with the broader side. Okay, just to first we begin, we have to just check this. Okay, when you use the tri-square, use a good light. Okay, and allow the light to pass through that gap. Okay, that will tell you the case where it is high, where it is low. Where it is low, you will see light. Okay, and where you see dark, it will be the higher point. Okay, that is how you have to check the level 90 degree or straightness, whatever. Okay. So I am going to hold this for the broader side, and we know again that these two sides are parallel because these are the machine side which is on the raw material. Okay, these are the rough cut, so we will use the parallel side, the most parallel sides to hold the job. Okay, again make sure hold the job more than 50%. Okay, and slightly above the jawline, you should able to feel the broader surface. Keep your hand on top you have to avoid anything. Okay, take a rough file. I am taking a rough file and I will do straight filing. I will not do cross filing because this is already almost even. You have to just remove the coating, the rust and coating. For that I will do straight filing. Okay, and you see what I am doing. I am using the file flat on the surface, rubbing it. Okay, and using the tip to hit. Okay, this should be your ideal practice whenever you use a file. Okay. This you can achieve only by practicing. Okay. Here you have to time and again you have to just clean the area so that it is tidy to work with. Use the brush, do not use your hands on any of the material, okay? So the material will have the burr. Okay? So that I'll show you later on what is burr and all. So avoid touching the material. Here I am switching the side. The face of the file I am switching just to refresh. Okay. Still I am not getting that resistance. Okay. Since the job is not yet hot. Okay. It is very hot. It's turned hot and soft. Thank you.